Hey y'all, it's Jeff Lafferty, and back for another show, Birdcast type thing. Still haven't figured out a name for it, but will eventually. It's number 15, which is really cool. 15 days down the road with no job. Anyway, sorry for the long pause I started. I think I was hearing some stuff out there. I'm not recording this at my usual time. I'm recording this at night. It's about 10:30. I actually have to kick this recording off at 10:45 because there's just no way if I do my usual hour-long video that I'm going to actually get it up on the web for you guys tomorrow. So this is going to be a kind of a short one, but as you can see, working on different piece than actually the Wolverine piece. Thought I'd give that one a break for today. That one's real close to being done. I might just record the very finish of it in the next video. It might actually just not. That might be the last video of it, because it might get done before I shoot again. But it'll be up on the website pretty soon. You guys can check out what the finish is. But I just felt super inspired last night to drop my pencil to do another to actually do another painting, because I've been kind of trying to do a drawing each night, you know, like a rough kind of drawing. And I don't know, it kind of started with those Robin Hood pieces. You know, I put them on Facebook and everybody, the reaction to was really enthusiastic, and so I tried put them on eBay, and they've just been selling consistently. So I just went ahead and kept doing them, just made it kind of a nightly ritual, do one and just kind of try out all sorts of things and just see what sells, what doesn't, and what I like drawing. It's, you know, without sort of having to commit so much to doing a full painting. And I tell you, the more I did them, the more I kind of was like, you know, could I actually be painting these things? I think I've said that before. You know, I used to be just a fanatical sketcher, and a lot of times in my sketchbooks I would do, you know, a small painting in like a day. And I used to remember when I was doing sketch cards, and I'd have such a hard time getting a sketch card done in like 8 hours, you know. And because I would do them like really painted, you know. You want to check them out, you know, hit my website and take a look. Just looks like, just, you know, like this piece here. And just always be like, God, how come it takes me so long to do like a little 2.5 by 3.5 inch painting? You know, I used to be able to knock these out in my sketchbook without even thinking in an hour or so, you know. But maybe better on stupid tape is getting kind of worn down. It's not wanting to hold the piece where I want it to. Trying to darken this sort of lacy type thing she's got on up a little bit so it looks a little closer. But anyway, what I was saying was, you know, I really would have a hard time doing those sketch cards quickly. And I remember thinking when I first started doing them, I was like, you know, I'll probably be able to do a couple of these cards a day or something. And a lot of times, man, it would take me a day or so to do one. And I don't know, I also had a friend, Sean Tiffany, a lot of you guys know, you know, who followed me for a while, know him. He was like the co-host of the podcast I was doing for a while, and just a friend of mine forever. We were like old friends from a long time ago. I used to go over to his house for lunch, you know, every Saturday or something. I don't remember what day it was. It was like on the weekends though, and you know, we just had the habit of like I'd bring whatever I did that week, and he'd show me what he did that week, and just, you know, kick back and talk art and talk all sorts of things, you know, whatever the heck was going on with us, you know, girls, however we were, weren't making money at the time, you know. He was like self-publishing a comic back then called, was it Exit 6? Yeah, and the one he's doing now is called, Oil Can Drive, that's right. I don't know why I even hesitated when I was thinking of that. It's just, you know, it's not like I couldn't remember, for crying out loud. It's a good webcomic, by the way, if any of you guys, you know, are looking for something to read. Actually, I should totally get on a rant about that at some point, about how damn good that comic is, and how nobody watches or is looking at it. But anyway, I'm going to save that for a bit. Because I used to always kind of go over to his house, and he, you know, one of the things I used to do back then was I'd hit life drawing like all the time. I was a fanatical sketcher, like I said, but I really believed in going to life drawing sessions, and just thought it was one of the best ways to learn how to draw. And I would go to like 3 a week sometimes. I'd go down to Denver, and there's a couple here in Boulder I would go to. And just a lot of life drawing. And, you know, whenever I'd go see Sean, I'd always have like a stack of like my sketches. I'd pull out the good ones and bring them, you know, so I'd have like 6 or 7 pieces at least. And then I'd have whatever I was working on, like whatever painting or something like that. And oftentimes it'd be like, you know, I'd show it to him 1 week, and then I'd bring it back the next week, and I'd be a little bit further on it. And I also would have my sketchbook. And my sketchbook would always have all these drawings and stuff in there. And I remember him asking me one time, and this is like something where, you know, you do learn from your friends whether you want to admit it or not, but, you know, he said to me, like, or he said at least once to me, probably many times, like, what's the difference between, like, the sketchbook in like the finished pieces, you know what I mean? We did these tables one time at a restaurant. It was just, I don't know how he came across this kind of a job type thing. But anyway, they were this restaurant wanted all these tables painted, and so they found all these artists, and we all had a table. They were just like a little coffee shop table, you know, whatever. 3 or 4 feet by 3 or 4 feet kind of thing. And we all just went in there one night, and then one night we painted our table and you know, called it good. And they varnished them as we were leaving, and it was kind of neat because, you know, whenever we would go in there, you could always, you know, I'd always go over and see how the varnish was holding up on my table kind of thing, you know. But, you know, like that night, I remember, you know, just not being ready to paint that thing, and I had some pictures of a girl that I knew, and just was like, oh, I'm just going to paint this picture, you know. We kind of decided as we were driving over there, and, you know, just sat down and pretty much easily painted the table in one night, and Sean did his, and you know what I mean, and I remember him saying that. It's just like, what's the difference between, you know, like, well, you know, basically saying, like, why are you having such a hard time doing your finished stuff, and, compared to, like, when you have to paint a table, or when you open up your sketchbook, or whatever, because a lot of my sketches would look very finished. I should get out a sketchbook and just show you guys sometime. And I didn't really have an answer back then, you know, but it's like, for one thing, I think that, you know, sometimes, like with the Wolverine piece I just did, it's like the complexity of the piece. And the complexity sometimes will slow me down. Not just because it's hard, but because it's, like, complex. You know what I mean? It takes some thinking to figure out, like, where figures go and how they connect and things like that. Because, like, one thing I did when I did this piece is I was kind of thinking along those same lines. I was like, can I draw this in one night? Let me see. And as you can see, I hear somebody talking outside. kids screaming. There's some kids playing hide and seek or something. But anyway, one of the goals with this piece was just to kind of like just try to get it done in the night, which I didn't get it done in the night, but I only had, you know, like, by the time I kind of really got geared up to go for this thing, it was like about 11 or 12 o'clock, you know, so I think I went to about 3 in the morning or something and just called it good. And then, you know, I think I mentioned I had to, like, you know, paint the trailer, get it all fixed up because of all this baloney with the trailer park. Yeah, I live in a trailer park. And so I've been kind of like getting up and going out and working on that stuff for a few hours before I even get into here. And, you know, it just has to be done or I have to go look for a new place to live. And it's just, you know, I don't have time to do that right now. So it's been taking up a little bit of my time. So I didn't, you know, like today I got going on this thing at about 1 again. So, and I don't know, went out and ate dinner about 5:30 or something, so that's like 4 hours. And then, you know, the night before was like 4 hours, so that was, you know, it's about 8 hours to here. But it's just, there's a lot more steps to go all the way to color, but I feel like I'm moving quickly on this one anyway, and I feel like it's just as good as anything else I've done. In fact, I really like it. I think it might be a little better, and it's actually a little bigger. But I think, I mean, my point is, it's just like, I kind of realize is it's not so much that I'm drawing slower when I get on these bigger commissions and I have a hard time, kind of, or I feel like it's, you know, it goes like, you know, day one, day two, day three, day four, you know what I mean? And sometimes it's like day five, for crying out loud. But it's not so much going slower. Actually, what I want to do, I think, because this was supposed to be all kind of black, so I think I'm going to kind of actually get the black out and paint a little black in here before I hit with some lights. And I'm just going to hit some highlights there, but I think I think that it's not like I'm drawing or painting slower. I think the majority of time I'm actually painting pretty fast, but it's just, more the complexity of a piece sometimes, you know, that actually, like when I sit down with one of those drawings, I'm more focused because I know that I'm going to get it done in about 3 hours, and I'm going to put it on eBay or whatever, or scan it, put in my, just looking for my good brush, so hopefully you guys can hear me. As usual, I only have one, and it's getting kind of worn out. I think I need to go buy one tomorrow. But, yeah, like, when I am doing one of those, like a drawing, I'm more kind of focused just because I know I'm going to get it done in a few hours. Whereas with, like, a painting, sometimes I think when you come back to it, yeah, you're not as focused sometimes, you know. You're not, like, attacking it as hard on day two when you're kind of getting started again as you were on the first day. Or at least I don't feel like I do sometimes. So I don't know why I brought all that up. It's kind of like stream of consciousness kind of thinking about my art. I don't know if anybody else really even knows what I'm talking about. But, at any rate, what is it? It's 10:46 right now. Should probably really get off, but it's kind of a drag. I wanted to record today, but, you know, what I should have done was recorded while Tristan and Tanya were taking a nap, you know. But I was just going so good on this piece, I just thought, I just don't want to mess with the camera right now, you know. And, and all that, so. But I appreciate everybody's awesome comments and stuff lately. Even though I haven't been able to get to them as good as I wanted to. I guess in the last video I was calling, Nicole Goff. I was calling her Michelle Goff. I'm sorry about that. Sophara pointed that out, and I appreciate that. I don't know. I'm horrible with names anyway. And now I'm painting way over here on the corner. You guys can't even see what I'm painting. Like way on the edge of our thing. I'm just kind of throwing some of the blacks back in though, you know. Then I'll just hit it with the hairdryer. I'm not really blending or anything, but I want it to be black here. And I don't like using black colored pencils. I think I've mentioned that, especially because I don't want any gray blending in with my work. Yeah, which that is something though that is actually one of the old masters thing that is kind of taught when you learn that old master's technique though, is to add gray to your paint to change the to do the value scale, which maybe I'll talk a little bit more about that at some point, but I actually don't agree with that. Just for myself, I'm not like, you know, reinventing art and telling everybody how to do it, but what else? I guess that's about it. Sorry, I have to kind of cut it short though, but well, I'll have a better one. Actually, tomorrow I'm going to be on Peter Palmiotti's podcast. I think I might have mentioned that already. Called The Independent Road, and it's really cool. He's been on my podcast before, and been on his also before. But it's just fun to chat with him. I really like the guy, and I know he wants to talk about kind of, or I'm guessing, I don't know what he wants to talk about. I'm guessing he wants to talk about, like, you know, the whole thing with, like, leaving your job and, you know, that kind of stuff, which, you know, it's like that stuff is on my mind and I'm itching to talk about it. Sometimes I'm, like, hesitant to, like, just go off on a rant forever because it's like, you know, I almost feel, you know, it's funny, you almost feel guilty sometimes when you do something like this. Because it's like, you know, as much as you don't want to go to work or whatever, and, you know, you just accept that you do, and you accept it in the sense that, you know, you got to feed your family and all that kind of stuff. So it's like, it's alright that you got to do stuff you don't want to do, right? And all that, you know, that's just being a man or whatever, you know. Or a woman, you know. It's, not everybody's got people depending on them, but you still always have yourself depending on yourself, you know. But, you know, it's funny. It's like, you know, just staying home. You know, it's like you almost feel a little guilty in a way. Because you're like, I mean, if you can paint a painting that you know, you can get paid for, then it's basically just, you don't need to go there anymore. Because you can just stay home and paint, right? You know? I mean, that's kind of my thing. But, you know, it's like, in some ways, you almost feel bad for the guys that you leave behind, in a way. It's kind of weird. It's like, you know, surviving Vietnam or something, you know. You kind of look back at the guys you left there, and you go, jeez, wish I could have got them all out, too, you know. So it's kind of, like, way overly dramatic, but I don't know. But anyway, I'm looking forward to talking to Peter, because he'll probably get me really riled up, and I'll start really ranting or raving about, you know, working and all that, and that'll be a fun listen. And I appreciate everybody doing all the shares. I appreciate all the comments, like I said, but the shares are really cool. I really appreciate that. Thanks for everybody that's bought my stuff. And everything like that. So hope this made kind of sense. I didn't have any idea what I was going to talk about, but sometimes those make the best ones for some reason. Anyway, I'll see you guys tomorrow. I'll try to record a longer show. I don't know if I'll be able to show you this piece when it's done. Thanks.